say something about the body, because sometimes people say, so do you mean you just cut it off and you move from here and that's it? What about the whole body? Oh. What's, is that a question?
Sure.
Yeah. What happened to the whole body? And that's why I said from the beginning that in any activity in the body, they're living parts, you know, like if you move to pick up something, right? There's some parts that are involved, and there's some parts that follow you because, you know, we know from the martial arts, I mean, it's logical. We know from the Alexander work, we know Feldenkrais work, Pilates, you know, yoga, of course, but we know that they all base on coordination. It's how the body coordinates. This is, in a way, you know, this is the coordination of the body parts that are involved in playing. You know, the legs don't play the piano, they do push the pedal down, but it's not the whole, but the body is very important. And of course, as you know, first of all, you can see the upper arm follows, but there's a huge difference. So the body and the body is the arm. If you want to stay connected, you can't just stay centered, right? You can't stay where you were all the time as you go in front of the body. I can tell you that when it comes to going down or for the left leg going up in front of the body, I move people's body to the degree that the forearm can really be there. I mean, it's in front of the body. And the response very often is, my God, I've never been there. You know, that we're playing more here, but see, so the body has a crucial role to following and make it possible for the leading parts to be able to function in the way that they have to function. Again, the coordination alignment, what does it mean? You know, so it's, the body is important, is that clear? The body is important in the way that it's making it possible for the leading parts. Now the whole question of why are they the leading parts? Because this, I would say that the forearm really has been what I would say a forgotten limb part. And you know, as I work with some of you, right, that just to turn it and to free it, it's like frozen. It's like we're not aware that we ever had that part. So why is it the forearm? You know, when you check, when you study or you experiment with the different parts that can move, because we've been told so much about the upper arm, relaxing it and moving from it, the fingers move very, very quickly. The hand is the next part, right? So if you move just from the hand, you are twisting, right? When you move from the forearm, with the rotational movements that are connected to other movements, is the only movement that can move as quickly as the fingers go up and down. So the forearm is really what takes a leading part and in the pedagogy of it, because this is so far, the feeling of freedom is so far, you know, letting it fall with gravity, is that we teach it first from, like, the forearm is leading. If I'm going from finger to finger, the fingers usually are so tight. People's fingers are so tight and so prepared to play. And the forearm is so tight also, already as a result of it. But this is the movement, the first thing that we teach people, and there may be a lesson or two here. I mean, the master classes will be basically playing and whatever it is that the person wants. It can be musical, it can be technical, it can be both, concentrating on both. But I started working, like with you, Rick, with one other person, on how to employ the rotational movements, because that's what's underneath a natural technique. You know, the feeling of how do we move from finger to finger without stretching. In other words, there has to be a solution. The body provides the answers to all of those things if we can't stretch. And we can't stretch. Because the moment we stretch, we also can't move the fingers. So we have all that finger work that we do, and we also stretch. So it makes it impossible for the fingers to do, but the fingers can move if something else moves them across. If something else moves them into the black key and out of the black key. But it's a coordinated effort. And what we see in the hand are finger movements because the wrist becomes so small. And it is really an art. It's not an easy thing to teach all of this. Because it's not, it's a diagnostic technique. And you can say things to people, and people sometimes don't respond. The body doesn't know what it means. So you have to find many, many different ways to get that moving, to get that working. So this is why this is the part that leads, and how it leads is the complexity of, you know, what involves emotion. You know, play is a study of motion.